Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to another lecture in topology. In today's lecture we are going to discuss metric spaces. So a non-empty set with a metric defined on it is called a metric space. Now let's define what a metric is. So let us consider a non-empty set X. So let X be a non-empty set then a function D from X cross X to R is called a metric if for all X Y and Z belonging to X, it satisfies the following axioms. So we consider a non-empty set X, then a function D from the Cartesian product of the set X with itself to the set of real numbers. This means that the function D takes an ordered pair from the set X and joins that ordered pair to a real number. And this function D is also called a distance function. So here D is also called distance function. Okay, so this distance function takes an ordered pair and joins it to a real number. So this function is called a metric if it satisfies the following axioms. Number one, so this distance between X and Y is greater than or equal to 0. Number two, D of XY is equal to 0 if and only if X is equal to Y. And number third, D of XY is equal to D of YX. D of XZ is less than or equal to D of XY plus D of YZ. So if the distance function satisfies these axioms, then it is called a metric on the set X. So these are the properties that that distance function is always greater than or equal to 0. So this means that it is always non-negative. So this is non-negativity property. So non-negativity and also, so this distance function will be equal to 0 if and only if X and X is equal to Y, and the distance function between X Y will be the same as the distance between Y and X. And if we have any three points X, Y and Z, then D of XZ will be less than or equal to D of XY plus d of yz. So this property is called triangular inequality. So the function d from x cross x to r is called a metric if it satisfies these axioms, and then the set X together with that metric is called a metric space. So the pair X comma D is called a metric space. Now let us consider some examples of metrics and metric spaces. So now we consider the set of real numbers with a distance function, and we are going to prove that that distance function is a metric on the set of real numbers. So the set of real numbers is a metric space. So here we consider our set X is the set of real numbers. So let the distance function d of xy be equal to x minus y mod. So here you can see that X minus y mod is a function which shows the distance between any two points, the distance between any two real numbers x and y on the real number line. So if we have our number line, if this is point X and if this is point y, then this distance is given by x minus y mod. Now let us see if this distance function satisfies the axioms of a metric. So number one, so here this distance is always greater than or equal to 0. So this is never negative. So d of xy, which is x minus y whole mod, so this is always greater than or equal to 0. So the first condition of a metric is satisfied. So number two, now d of xy, which is equal to x minus y mod, so this is equal to 0. So if this is equal to 0, then this implies x minus y is equal to 0. So this implies x is equal to y. So d of xy is equal to 0 if x is equal to y. So the second condition is also satisfied. And number three, d of xy, which is here x minus y mod, we can also write this as y minus x whole mod. So by definition this will be equal to d of yx. So d of xy is equal to d of yx. So this is also another axiom of a metric. Or number four, so d of x and z, so x and z are any two real numbers, will be equal to x minus z mod. Okay, so we can write this as x minus y plus y minus z whole mod. So d of xz is equal to this thing. We can also write it further, d of xz is less than or equal to x minus y mod plus y minus z mod. So here we use the property that a plus b whole mod is less than or equal to a mod plus b mod. So it also satisfies the triangular inequality. So this is triangular inequality. Hence, this distance function d of xy is equal to x minus y whole mod is a metric on the set of real numbers. So hence d is a metric on R. So R together with this metric d, R comma d is a metric space. So the set of real numbers with its usual distance function between any two real numbers is a metric space. Now let us consider another example of metric space. So the same kind of metric can be defined on the set of complex numbers. So if we consider our set X equal to set of complex numbers C, and we consider the metric D of Z1, Z2 equal to Z1 minus Z2 mod. Here Z1 and Z2 are any two complex numbers. So now we will see that the set of complex numbers with this metric is a metric space. So now let us check for all the axioms of the metric. Number one, here Z1 minus Z2 whole mod is always greater than or equal to 0. This is not negative. So D of Z1 Z2 is greater than or equal to 0. Also D of Z1 comma Z2, which is Z1 minus Z2 mod, if this is equal to 0, then this implies Z1 minus Z2 is equal to 0, so which implies Z1 is equal to Z2. So this distance function will be equal to 0. So D of Z1 Z2 will be equal to 0 if and only if Z1 is equal to Z2. So we can also prove it other way around, that if we suppose Z1 is equal to Z2, then we can show that D of Z1 Z2 is equal to 0. Number 3, now D of Z1 Z2, which is Z1 minus Z2 mod, so we can also write it as Z2 minus Z1 mod, so which by definition is D of Z2 Z1. So the third condition is also satisfied. Number 4, D of between any two complex numbers, suppose this time we consider it D of Z1 Z3, so which will be equal to by definition Z1 minus Z3 mod, we can write it as Z1 minus Z2 plus Z2 minus Z3. Okay, so D of Z1 Z3, now if we take the modulus or mod of these two terms separately, then we have D of Z1 Z3 is less than or equal to D of Z1 minus Z2
plus d of z2 z3. So this is triangular inequality property. So this was non-negativity.
So this distance function between any two complex numbers defined by z1 minus z2 whole mod, so it satisfies the axioms of a metric. So this is a metric on the set of complex numbers. So the set of complex numbers is a metric space. So let's have another example of metric space. Now we consider the example of a metric space which is called discrete metric space.
So for all x and y belonging to the set of real numbers, if we consider the distance function as d of xy equals 0 if x and y are equal and 1 if x and y are not equal.
So we will prove that this is a metric on the set of real numbers. So here, from here we can see that d of xy is either 0 or 1. So this is, so d of xy is greater than or equal to 0. Secondly, d of xy is equal to 0 only if x is equal to y. So second condition is also satisfied. Also d of xy which is equal to 0 if x is equal to y and 1 if x is not equal to y. So we can write this whole thing as 0 if y is equal to x and 1 if y is not equal to x. So by definition of, so by definition you can see that this is equal to d of yx. So hence d of xy is equal to d of yx. Now we check for the triangular inequality.
There is d of xz is less than or equal to d of xy plus d of yz. So first, in the first case, so here we have three numbers x, y and z. So in the first case we consider that x, y and z all are not equal. So then from here d of xz will be equal to, we know that if two numbers are not equal, then according to the metric, so that distance function will be equal to 1. So d of xz is 1. Similarly, d of xy, so this is also equal to 1, and d of yz, so this is also equal to 1. So here 1 is less than 1 plus 1. So this thing is true. So it means for this case, when x, y and z are all not equal, then this triangular inequality is satisfied. Now we consider case 2. So this was case 1. Now we consider case 2. Now we consider that x and y are equal and y is not equal to z. So now d of xz will be equal to, since x and z are not equal, so d of xz is 1 and d of xy, x and y are equal, so this will be equal to 0. Similarly, d of yz, y and z are not equal, will be equal to 1. So here, from here, d of xz, so 1 is less than 0 plus 1, so which is true. So again, for this case also, the triangular inequality is satisfied. Now we consider the third case, case 3. So when x and y are not equal and y and z are equal. So now d of xz, so x and z are also not equal. So x is not equal to y and y is equal to z. So here x and z are also not equal. So d of xz is equal to 1. So d of xy, so x and y are not equal. So this is 1. So d of yz, since y and z are equal, so d of yz is equal to 0. So from here, 1 is less than 1 plus 0. So in this case also, this is true. So hence, for all these three cases, this triangular inequality is satisfied. So triangular inequality is satisfied. So d of xy, which was given as 0 for x equal to y and 1 for x not equal to y. So this thing is a metric on R, and this metric is called discrete metric, and the set of real numbers R together with this metric is called a discrete metric space. So these were some of the examples of metric spaces. So in topology, every metric space is also a topological space. And this type of topological space is called a metric topology. So every metric space is also a topological space. So every metric space is also a topological space, and such a topology is called a metric topology. So every metric space is a topological space. We will prove this thing in a later lecture. So in today's lecture, we introduced the concept of a metric on a set X and a metric space. And then we saw that every metric space is a topological space. So with this, we come to the end of today's lecture. See you in the next lecture.